Right, so here we are again. 2 years ago, we were in exactly the same position in June, finding out what we were going to be having, whether it was a boy or a girl. And I've just dropped off Georgia at hospital because she's going in for a 20-week scan today, so we're going to find out what we're having. You may remember our video that we did last time, where we went in together, we did it privately, early, to find out what we're having, because we just couldn't wait, because we obviously had 8 boys between us, so we were just so eager to find out whether it was a girl or not, and obviously it turned out to be a girl, our little widow. But this time round it's a little bit different, because of coronavirus, we can't actually go in together, I've got to sit outside and wait in the car, so it's going to be a tense, anxious wait, and just got to wait for Georgia to come out of those doors and tell us what we're having. We've done all the DIY tests you can think of at home. Sent the scan pictures to every Tom, Dick and Harry that's meant to be able to tell us just from looking at the scan picture what we're having, but it's been a very mixed result, so we're really not sure. Some family members think that we're having a boy, some think we're having a girl, some of our dreams are having a boy, some of our dreams are having a girl. It's really, really undecided. Obviously last time we were quite certain we're having a girl before we even found out we had a name and everything. We've got names this time round. This time it will be Summer for a girl, Samuel for a boy. It would be amazing if we had another girl. But obviously, no matter what we have, as long as it's a happy, healthy baby, then we're happy as well. But yeah, I'll be amazed if it is another girl after all these boys. And it'll be someone for Willow to play with. Be able to relate to it a bit more, because, you know, the boys are a bit rough and tumble. But everyone loves her so much, and you know, she's got everyone right around her little finger. See, since then, we've had Willow, and we've got married since, and I thought last time would be the last time, but you know, things happen, and here we are again, so.
Right, so we've just come to McDonald's just to kill a bit of time. Georgie's still waiting for the scan. Obviously, with the current situation, things are a bit more slow moving, a bit behind, maybe. But yeah, just keeping the children entertained. Say hello, Jamie. And you can see Willow's head. Willow? Willow? There you go.
Right, so I've just got a message from Georgie telling me that she's on her way out. So any second now, just...
What is it?
Is it in this envelope, is it?
It's in the envelope.
Oh, God. Shut up. Shut up. <It's>... Really?
Yeah.
Look. Oh, I'm shaking.
Me too.
No. Yes. Little Summer.
She said that's her opinion, but she can't see any dangly bits.
Oh, that's as good as, isn't it? We're having a go! Yay! Right, so with that good news, we're going to go and tell Georgie's parents, and then we're going to tell the kids at home. Everyone's been isolating all this time, so Georgie and her mum may share a hug. Hashtag social distancing and all that, but yeah, hello, ready?
No, we're all ready.
Go and knock on the door.
Go on in.
Oh, Jamie,
Willow.
Thank you.
In terms of parenting, having a girl completely changes my views and outlook and perspective on things from a man's point of view. I don't know what it's like with mums, whether they're tougher on boys, less tough on girls or what, but I can definitely say from a father's point of view, as you know, certainly from my point of view, I have really gone soft. I have gone really soft with Willow. She's probably going to have me back around a little finger when she's a bit older. But I always used to take the mick out of Georgie for being soft with her boys, but I think it's rubbed off on me a bit. So, yeah.